What was the first symptom?
The first symptom?
Mm-hmm.
Chills, fever.
The Praetorian Guard! 10,000 furious licentious men?
Ready? Cute.
Cute.
They were Romans.
Spider Callahan has a Roman nose and he's cute.
He gives me the creeps.
Okay, alright.
Am I the only one interested in graduating?
Or would you all rather repeat?
Graduation, I can hardly wait.
It'll be wonderful.
Imagine being turned loose into the world.
Yeah. What if it's the other way around? Well, you'll never find out if you get another zero on a history quiz.
A zero? Betty?
A real crusade.
Not for everything.
I guess it's useless to remark that I did not know the answers.
Well, I'm glad you kept them to yourself. We wouldn't want confidential information about the Roman Empire to leak out.
Oh, stop.
Actually, she did know the answers.
Then why?
She couldn't read the questions.
How do you know?
Oh, Betty Anderson, as your dearest friend, I know your vision is not 20/20. You can't read the blackboard from the 8th row unless you wear your glasses.
I guess not.
Then why did you tell the teacher you forgot your glasses?
Because they were in her purse.
Jane.
Now why? Why would a girl flunk an exam and then put on her glasses? What possible reason could there be?
Who is he?
Who? I'm in history class.
Never mind.
Must be some crush I feel for you.
Thanks. Mm-hmm.
If he only knew what a noble sacrifice he had made.
We ought to tell him.
You wouldn't dare.
He might even notice, Betty.
He does notice. I caught him twice, looking at me.
Yeah, he probably had that prickly feeling on the back of his neck.
Ever since you took off your braces, you've been acting nasty.
Hey, maybe that's him. Ready to say he's madly looking?
Probably a wrong number.
Hey!
I have to answer.
Don't you let it ring 3 times in case the boy?
Why?
Don't be so available.
Okay. Hello? It is? Yes, it's me. You're kidding. Yes, I'd love to. I'll be ready. Goodbye. It was him. It was Ralph.
That's the one.
Maybe that zero was an investment.
He has to go roller skating tonight.
Tonight?
Should I wear formal or look casual?
He's pretty casual, phoning up the last minute.
I'm sorry. Are you sure you can even go?
Of course I'll go.
Don't you have to ask your folks?
Ask my folks?
I have to get permission for my dates.
Not me. I'm 18. That's old enough to be drafted.
I wish my father could see it that way.
Father is very reasonable. Anyhow, he trusts me.
A parent being reasonable. Funny, Betty.
It's 4 o'clock! Only 3 hours to get ready!
I thought you'd go look casual.
Takes hours getting that casual look.
Okay. Well then.
Do we go home or are we supposed to stick around and scrub her back?
Scrub her back? Personally, I'm gonna finish my lemonade.
Margaret, I'm home! Oh, hello, girls.
Oh, hello, Mr. Anderson.
Oh, Mr. Anderson.
Yeah, sorry about that. We were just meeting. Betty went upstairs.
Yeah.
Thanks, Mr. Anderson.
Goodbye, Mr. Anderson.
Adios.
Goodbye, girls. Margaret, great news. Know that new factory that's opening up? Who do you think's gonna do their insurance accounts? fire, theft, flood, accident, employer's liability. Don't start spending the commission. I'm trading in the car. Margaret? Where have you been?
The basement.
What were you doing in the basement?
Jim, do you think a washing machine can have a soul?
A soul? Nonsense.
Well, our washing machine does.
Oh?
It watches me sorting out the clothes and things. I'll get it for this.
Then why don't you get it fixed?
He did. I called the repairman yesterday. He turned it on and it worked for him.
Then call again.
But when he turns it on, he looks at me. I can't stand any more of those looks.
Now don't get hysterical.
I'm going to take the stupid clothes down to the river and beat them with a rock. It's either that or a new washing machine.
New washing machine?
Jim, that monster in the basement has paid me off for all of my clothes.
Well, maybe we can manage that. If this insurance comes through.
It better.
How'd you like to take a little drive this summer? Maybe go up to Canada?
Not a new car, Jim, a washing machine.
Mr. Brinkworth's coming over tonight.
Who?
Brinkworth, the man who's opening up the new factory.
Oh, that's your secretary called.
He called? Today?
Yeah, he said you expected him?
Yes, yes.
He isn't coming.
What?
His son has a day and he's letting him use the car. He was very sorry.
Sorry?
Message is on the phone.
Oh, that's fine. Just fine.
He was sorry.
What if the place burns down?
Now, Jim.
Let it burn as long as Junior has his fun.
I don't think one day will make much of a difference.
I resent our going out with the essentials. Some young fool and his dick.
Oh, you're just hungry.
Starved.
I'll go start dinner.
Start dinner?
Why, yes.
Isn't it ready?
What do you think I've been doing all day?
Hey, you look terrible. Are you like feeling sick or something?
No, actually, I feel great. How about I go change into a pinafore?
What?
Mother! Do I have a slip on it?
Check your drawer!
Which one?
Oh, don't be so helpless!
I wish you wouldn't yell at the children.
Never mind, Mother! I found one!
Hey, Dad. Is dinner ready yet?
Just a minute, bud. You'll have to wait like the rest of us.
That is what I figured.
Daddy!
Excellent.
I have to ask you something.
Mm-hmm.
You'll say no.
Maybe.
You will! I know it!
Now don't be so sure.
So, again, really?
Of course, go ahead.
Yippee!
Always, she gets her way. Well, a perfectly reasonable thing like... like... what? Perfectly reasonable thing.
Father?
Yes, Betty?
I need your advice.
What is it?
Do men really dislike nail polish?
Oh, for heaven's sakes.
According to the recent poll, they do.
Well, then.
Then they turn around and date a girl with nail polish.
Sounds pretty conclusive.
Suppose they don't date a girl because of her nail polish.
You want my advice?
Yes.
Play it safe. Wear nail polish on one hand.
You don't care!
Hey, Dad, get this.
Yes?
Listen closely. If it takes three men working 8-hour shifts, 4 days to dig a ditch 53 feet by 6 feet by 3 feet,
got that? 53B. Three men. You left him now.
I did not.
It's important. I'll read it again. It takes three men working 8-hour shifts, 4 days to dig a ditch 53 feet by 6 feet by 3 feet. Did you get it?
I'm confused.
Well, there's a ditch and you're digging it 50 by 6 feet by.
Unless it is a ditch.
Yes.
It takes three men working 8 hours.
Margaret, we assume they had a shovel.
It would be just like a ditch without a shovel.
You got the answer, the dad.
Read the rest of the problem.
How long would it take three men working 8-hour shift to dig the same ditch?
Three men, 8-hour shift.
Why would they want to dig the same ditch?
Three men. Okay, and then they're working 8-hour shift.
You get it?
No.
You want to see it?
No, I want to read my paper. After a long day's work, I feel entitled to a few simple pleasures.
Okay,
that is if nobody must.
You.
Can we eat without all this fuss?
This? Oh no, we're eating in the kitchen tonight.
Then what's that?
It's my garden club candles for the show tomorrow.
Oh, garden club.
See, don't you think it looks like a wedding table? Venus, tis thy wedding day.
Whose wedding day?
No, it's the title. It's the reception table.
More like something you crumb under if the mosquitoes get pesky.
Oh, at 95 cents a yard?
95 cents a yard? No wonder they asked you to do it.
Well, Miss Wendy, you should have seen her face when they asked me to do it. She felt like it was her table.
Ha! Listen to this. Here's a boy, 16, eloped with the girl, 15.
Think of that.
And his father let him use the car. Finally turned up in Kansas City.
How awful.
What's so awful about Kansas City?
When they found them, all they had were $3 and a couple candy bars.
You know, I know a guy, Jerry Allen. He lives in Kansas City.
Shows what comes from letting kids run us.
Jerry said he liked the beer just fine.
Ought to send this to our Brickworth.
15, 16, just babies.
What goes on in the minds of young people?
I gotta tell you something. This candy bar will ruin your teeth.
You probably need a good wall.
Jim, you don't understand children. One minute they're great in the refrigerator and talking about us, then for grandparents.
But finish your homework upstairs.
Why?
You heard me, go here.
Always, I'm involved.
Then?
I don't understand why you're so shocked at the idea.
When I'm ready to be a grandparent, I will say so.
You don't have anything to say about it.
Oh, and why not?
Children grow up, go their own way.
Well, they haven't grown up yet.
You have an 18-year-old daughter.
Betty, she's in high school.
She'll be out in a couple months.
And on her way to college.
I hope so.
Margaret, what do you mean? Of course she's going to call.
I'm just saying you can't be so certain about this thing.
Hey, you know, Betty, she hasn't been acting funny, has she?
In what way?
Well, you know, about boys?
Well, she likes boys.
She does? Well, I mean, anyone in particular.
I don't know.
You don't know?
But Jamie, you can't just follow children around.
And why not? Because they're driving somewhere in a car.
Stupid newspaper story.
Every time I pick up the paper lately, Betty's been up to something. And I mean young people. Not Betty. Betty's not attention. Young people. Young people are up to things. In the paper.
Jim! Jim, you don't understand. Betty is not even thinking about Betty moping, so why worry about it?
Mother, will dinner be ready soon?
Can't hear it anymore, it's coming.
I need at least an hour to get ready.
Going formal here?
No, I'll play it safe and look casual. What on earth?
It's my garden club table.
Oh, garden club. Tis thy wedding day.
Whose wedding day? Nobody's, it's the title. This is the reception table where they cut the cake and everybody throws rice.
How silly.
Wasn't my idea.
Why don't they just elope? That's what I intend to do.
Darling,
you do?
Darling, don't talk nonsense.
Nonsense? What would be more romantic than he and I driving off into the sunset, only thinking of each other?
You'll change your mind.
Never. Supper must be ready. I smell it burning.
Oh, me too.
Mother, I wanted to tell you not to wait up tonight. It'll be all ours.
Betty?
Yes.
What will be all ours?
The thing tonight.
Wait, come back here. I think we need to have a little chat.
Right now?
Sit down. I'd like to know more about this thing.
Thing more?
A thing covers a pretty wide field.
Well, there's this boy in my history class.
Aha!
You wouldn't know the trouble I went through getting him to notice me.
Trouble?
You see, there are so many cute girls in my class. It's quite frankly amazing that—
Yes, okay. But let's get to the part where he noticed you.
He was always staring at me when he thought I didn't notice.
Who is this boy?
Oh, he's darling. Not pretty? Sort of rugged, but not football rugged. There's too much stuff upstairs. I want to put him in the dream boat class.
Yes. But who is he? What's his name?
Ralph.
What?
Ralph. That's funny. I can't remember.
You can't remember?
When you close your eyes, you forget what a person looks like when you like them.
So in other words, you don't know his last name.
But I do.
Only you can't remember. Okay, what about his family?
Well, we haven't quite exactly met.
Haven't met? Betty, where are you going with this boy?
To go roller skating. At Lakeside?
Lakeside? Betty, that's a long way out.
He has a car tonight.
Oh, he does he?
Dad, can we put our car in the garage just for tonight?
Our car?
Old wreck in front of the house? People get the wrong idea.
And by people, you mean Ralph.
Well, maybe he just won't notice in the dark.
Won't notice?
Or maybe he's just not like that.
Well, maybe I better find out what he is like.
I just told you!
From what you just told me, he sounds like an irresponsible young playboy.
He is not!
How do you know? Maybe his father's a gangster.
Gangster in Springfield?
Oh, Betty, let us shelter life.
Sheltered life of all the idiotic ideas.
And what's so idiotic about it?
Dad, just talk to Ralph. You'll see how ridiculous this is.
I intend to get roller skate.
What do you mean by that?
You can turn on the radio and roller skate right here.
Right here?
You can go roller skating next time.
Next time? There won't be a next time!
And why not?
If you don't understand, there's no reason trying to explain. Mother! He's being horrible!
What's the matter?
He says we can't go roller skating!
Who?
Ralph and I! We have to stay here!
Jim, now shut
up! I really want a chance to know this boy, that's all, before Benny goes driving all over the country in his car.
I'm sure this is... Really? Do you need to do this?
And what's so awful about spending an evening at home? I used to spend many evenings at your house.
But this is the 20th century!
Really? I'm glad you learned something in history class.
Of all the horrible things, Ralph and I just sitting around while everybody stares at us.
You don't have to sit around. There are plenty of good, fun, wholesome activities that you and Ralph can do.
Name one.
There are plenty of good, clean, fun, wholesome, great activities that you can do.
Name one thing!
Pop some corn, brother. Gather around the piano and sing.
We haven't got a piano!
Gather up a game of hearts.
Hearts?
Jim, are you sure this is really necessary? It seems to spoil them. Shame to spoil them, Jim.
Spoil it? Spoil it? If more people spent more time at their house, they'd have more.
I think you mean less.
More girls leaving home. I thought you'd say no, but you said yes! But you promised!
Jim, if you promise.
I promise nothing.
You said!
Kathy, this is not a debate. Unpack the suitcase right now.
Mother?
Father knows best. Darling, you're dirty pajamas!
I forgot, Mother!
Miss Davis would have been shocked.
I'm sorry!
Why are you unpacking in here? Look, okay, I'm a reasonable man. All I ask is that I've got it. You can invite Patty over here to spend the night.
Here?
Over here?
Certainly.
Can we play hide and seek?
Of course.
You mean it?
Certainly. Call her up right now.
Use the phone upstairs?
I quit!
That woman.
She offered to come over here tonight with the girls.
More people.
It's just some girls. A few more won't make a difference.
More people.
Look, Bud and the boys are going to be in the basement. The girls are going to be upstairs. The guard club meeting's going to be in here.
Well, what about me?
Well, you have a porch. Wait, no. They have a porch. Betty and Ralph do.
Oh, they do?
You can have a kitchen. You can fix that cupboard that won't hang straight.
Look, I have to deal with this shiftless young Ralph character who's calling for Betty, and I've had a hard day already.
And it'll be quite a night, too. Let's go have dinner.
I have to,
But
yeah, sure.
What are you
my three soldiers.
They're digging a ditch.
They're being dirty.
They're my toy soldiers.
No, they're not. I bought them my own money.
Okay, children.
You can use my soldiers.
No, thanks.
You can have them for keeps.
Like I said,
no.
Quit following me!
Go roller skating?
Well, he may want to talk to you, ask him questions?
Questions?
Not to be prying. Just friendly interest.
In me.
He's interested in people.
Well, I'll do my best, but I can't tell him much about my mom. Well, I can't tell him much.
About what?
My mom's work.
Why?
Well, she's just opening up a new factory. The lease isn't signed, and it's just best not to go around broadcasting.
Is it a secret?
Not exactly. Shooting off your mouth before the details are all set.
I see.
I never knew you were glasses.
Just sometimes, for certain things. I forgot to take them off.
They look good.
They do.
Well, of course, you do look better without them.
Glad I don't have to wear them. They spoil a person's looks.
My mother wears glasses.
She does she?
She takes them off when she's going to a party, and when they see what a brave beauty she is, back go the glasses.
I think I'd like your mother.
She's just kidding about the brave beauty stuff.
Mind the trouble! I don't care if you have to take the whole thing apart!
That's fine.
Ought to train intelligent people to be mechanics. Ought to...
Father! This is Ralph! Ralph, meet my father.
How do you do?
Oh, must have picked up some grease. Sorry.
Don't bother. I'll go get a rag.
Well, trying to fix the washing machine, you know how it goes.
Sure. We haven't had much trouble with the new automatic, though.
New automatic?
Mom's afraid to let the maid use it. She does all the laundry herself.
Fancy that. Have any trouble parking your car?
What car?
I suppose you got a new car. Is it outside?
No, I took the bus.
The bus?
No use in taking Mom's car if you weren't going to Lakeside.
Very considerate of you.
Anyhow, most places you want to get, you can get there by bus.
Quite true.
Can't understand these people who can't get around without a car.
Oh, you get around quite a bit, I take it.
Mom says ever since we moved to Springfield, I've just been like a boarder.
Well.
No sense in ruining a perfectly good handkerchief.
What about me?
Oh, here.
So, you just moved. Where'd you move from?
A small town, downstate. Mom figured it was too small.
Too small?
Not enough room to operate up.
Operate? What does your mother operate?
It's confidential, Dad.
Confidential? I don't see.
Don't make it sound so mysterious.
Yeah, that's the way it sounds, all right.
Mom's opening up a new place.
What sort of place?
Well, I can tell you this much. It might mean a big difference to Springfield. Might even be new people moving in.
I'm not sure if that's a good thing.
Maybe you're right.
A lot depends on what kind of people.
Springfield's pretty nice the way it is.
Friendly.
Yeah.
Wide open, you might say.
He didn't say that. Now you're putting words into his mouth.
Okay. Let's approach this differently, eh?
Mr. Anderson, what are you trying to approach?
Say you were Betty's father. You might be concerned about the young men she goes out with. Their background, character.
Yes.
if you were concerned.
I'm concerned, all right.
Glad we agree on that. Now.
Jim?
Oh, what is it, Margaret?
Oh, this must be Ralph.
Ralph, my mother.
How about you, Ralph?
Oh, I cannot get those two girls to settle down.
Why not?
They're playing hide and go seek, and I can't seem to be it.
Don't play games. Deal with them.
I can't find them.
Then I'll deal with them. Kathy, what's her face? Come out here right now.
No use, Jack.
I better leave.
Leave?
He's measuring me with a blunt instrument.
No, I'm sorry. I don't think you understand. I'm Mrs. Brickworth.
Oh, so your husband's opening up a new factory?
No, I'm the one opening up a new factory.
But you're a woman. I sort of put my foot in things. The wife said I didn't know how hard it was to run the house.
My husband said the same.
Your husband does housework?
Yeah. But do you know what I tell him? I tell him, you're right, I don't know. And I don't want to know.
Well, you see, I took her up on it. Said I managed it. It's a little harder than I thought it would be, you know, keeping track of children.
Oh, I hate trying to keep track of my son.
Oh, you have a son?
Oh, yes. Ralph, Junior, named after my husband.
Ralph? How old is he?
Quite grown up. Almost 19.
Really?
Well, I suppose that's some girl's house.
Some girl's house?
Yeah. It's a funny thing, actually. He called her up, asking her to go roller skating with him, right? And then she calls back, insisting that he come over to her house.
Roller skating?
Ralph just couldn't understand. The girl changed her mind like that? Oh, that's why I'm here today, actually. See, he didn't need the car to drive. He didn't need to drive all the way up to Lakeside.
Lakeside?
Lovely place. I hear they have great music.
Crazy that him changing his mind like that.
Hey, yeah. Ralph just couldn't understand it at all, really.
Maybe she wasn't feeling well.
Perhaps. But do you know what I think?
What?
I think some old fool didn't trust his daughter out with my son.
My word. So what was she wearing?
I think she was wearing a pink and white dress.
A pink and white dress?
Like white shoes?
Like white shoes. Any identifying marks?
No.
Spots or scars?
No!
Hasn't been gone long. Oh, and officer, my car disappeared too. No, wait, don't transfer me to another department. She's probably in the car. J.F. Anderson, 21 Gateway Street. License number 7783. Hasn't been gone long. Goodbye.
Better we'll get back to Mrs. Greenforth.
Yes. Oh. Yes. Almost.
So I guess that covers three
there's a place where we sign.
I admire the way you make quick decisions.
Ah, yes, a few minor concessions. You see, you sign right there.
And I've never heard anyone so willing to listen to my ideas.
Yes, a few minor concessions. Just, if you're satisfied with the policy, you can just sign.
Oh, sign, sign. Yes.
What is it, but I'm busy?
Is that guy in a way?
He's fixing the washing machine.
Fixing it?
There's water all over the floor. So every time someone slips in it, they call it foul. I'm sorry, but you're gonna have to handle this one yourself.
Hey, fine.
I can't be everywhere at once, but.
Okay, you can do it.
I'm sorry for the interruption.
No, quite always. Daddy!
What is it, Kathy?
Patty says her father reads a girl's story every night.
Well, good.
She can't get to bed without a story.
Well, then she had no business leaving her own home.
Can we read a story in bed?
It's getting late. Fine.
What will we read?
A book.
All right, Daddy.
I'm sorry. I hope that's the last of it.
Oh, yeah, me too.
You stop right there.
Miss, don't mean to bother you.
No, but you will.
The kids down there. My mom?
Yes.
They have the right to break their own necks, and I ain't scared for myself.
Then what's the problem?
Talking getting punched with those machines.
Like you said.
Yeah.
Well, just tell them to be careful.
All right, follow.
Then make them be careful.
Sure about that?
Do whatever is necessary.
Hey, mister.
Takes a lot keeping the peace around here.
Peace? Oh, yes, the peace. Good. Daddy, have we got a book of riddles?
I don't know.
Patty likes riddles. She's crazy, but she's a guest.
Give her this.
But arithmetic book?
She likes fudge, she likes numbers.
That is an idea.
If it doesn't have enough, tell her to count sheep. Guess I handled that one.
Yes. All right, Anderson. It looks like you've got enough demands on your hands.
Yes, of course.
Yes, wind this up, won't we?
Oh, great. Your pen is the side as well.
Drop it off in my office tomorrow.
Tomorrow?
Yes. Unless, of course, you can't get away.
Oh, no.
I totally understand.
But it's okay.
Okay.
Yeah, tomorrow's fine.
Tomorrow?
Of course.
Okay.
Jim, have you heard from Brownwood?
This is Mrs. Brickwood.
Hello.
This is my wife.
Oh, nice to meet you.
How is it?
No, her husband is Ralph Brinkford. Her son is also Ralph Brinkford. Ralph Brinkford Senior, Ralph Brinkford Junior.
Yeah, naturally.
Naturally, yeah.
Okay, I'll be going then.
Okay. Yeah.
Oh. Busy evening you are having.
Go to the missing person.
Sorry, wrong
house. I'm sorry, Dragon.
Who is Jim Anderson saying we won't get you?
Sorry, I misunderstood.
Oh, officers, it won't be necessary.
You just sit tight. We'll find your daughter.
Your daughter? Is she? Oh,
no. Not at all.
It's just about a mistake. It's all about a mistake.
I don't
know. Perkins, but you're right. No strong arms, no handcuffs or bracelets.
Handcuffs?
Look, officer, you don't understand. I will draw the gun. I want to draw. The whole thing drawn. My daughter is not wayward, and she is not missing.
Then where is she?
I don't know. She went out.
Then she's missing.
You don't understand. I will draw. I will draw the look. I forgot my donations to the policeman's ball.
Put it away, mister.
Put it away?
What do you think you are?
Officer, attempted bribery. This man is obviously under a strain.
Well, baby.
I mean, just imagine, will you? Okay, imagine, just a normal citizen whose life goes along, you know, in a nice pattern, right? And I'm accustomed to having it disturbed.
What are you, a mouthpiece?
I'm merely pointing out the obvious.
Hey! Put them down! Let
them
out!
No! You couldn't help it. It was an accident.
Sir, that match would have to blow it. That damn pop's cool.
Hey!
Can't you
have it? What do you think you're doing?
Get out of here.
Hey, wait, but you can't leave it to...
Don't say it, mister. You're gonna give yourself a new job and I can get an elevator in for the old folks home.
I guess I shouldn't say anything more about the lock washing machine.
But you ought to see it. It looks like a scrap bowl. A trunk full of scrap metal will turn over the basement. That guy's an awful mean. He says that the drain hole is clogged. I say it's not. I guess I proved it too.
Bud, just tell your friends to go home.
Just let me get a chance to play you.
I'm sorry, it's been one day after another.
Wait, you're the one who told me to tell my fellows to go to come here.
I'm sorry, I just tell them to go home. You heard me. It's been a bad day.
Fine. One of those days.
Yes.
Guess I better stick around.
I'll stick around too.
Oh, now Mrs. Brinkworth.
Anderson, this is the time when you need a friend standing by you.
Take it away. quite a bit of gardening.
Excellent. We're always looking for girls who do things.
Of course, we are selective.
Actually, Mrs. Rickworth here would be a fine hire.
Well, if you say so.
Well then. Oh, the table, you want to see it.
A table?
Yes. This is my wedding ring.
Well, girls,
do you like it, Martha?
How do you feel, Gertrude?
Margaret!
Yes?
You carried out your idea.
It's lovely. Simply stunning.
I have just a few suggestions.
You do?
One or two little things.
Oh.
And he explained,
all his fault. He made a mistake that we were innocent victims.
Did he convince them?
He convinced them, all right. He had to explain it all over again in night court.
They couldn't keep him there?
That's what he said.
Ugh.
He said that they didn't know how to run things there. That they didn't even know what the charge was anyway.
What was the charge?
Disturbing the peace.
Oh, poor man.
Mrs. Brinkworth got off with the warning.
Was she very angry?
Blazing. Can she really get that fire?
I'm afraid so.
What a mess it caused!
Oh, you had plenty of help.
Maybe I should go down to the police station. Explain that it was all my fault.
Well, you know, you stay here. They're confused enough. I'm gonna call a lawyer. You're not in jail!
No. Just tired.
Are you alright?
Oh.
Are you out on bail?
Oh, well, funny story. The judge said he wanted to make an example of me.
He did?
Oh, yeah. But, you know, he couldn't figure out what I was an example of.
You haven't been fired yet, so...
Maybe I can start all over.
Of course we can.
Move to Alaska.
Must we go that far?
The farther, the better.
I can see us now, camping on an ice block. Today we... Blubber.
I haven't been in Des Moines or Kansas City.
Give me a place where there aren't any people.
Ha ha ha.
A bit unusual, isn't it?
unusual.
They have breakfast.
Oh! Well, you see, my daughter's friend, she's on a special diet. she needs lots of milk. She has ulcers. Lots of ulcers. Lots of milk.
Couldn't she just drink the milk?
No. The milkman has a covenant.
Oh, I see.
Betty, no, you're
not. Now, Anderson, after all we've been through together, I know you'll pick up a cold softie.
But
we have to make some allowances. And don't you worry, Anderson. I'll be chaperone.
Oh, yeah.
Gee, thanks.
Woohoo! Whoa! Whoopee! Yes! Oh, well, stop. Calm down. Calm down. I'm going. It's all going to be okay. Yeah. I'm gonna go get a job! Wait, what? Young man, get back here before you're late for school. School? School? I thought we were having a disaster. Whatever gave you that idea. Come on.
We girls, it's basically saying nothing will go farther than the international press.
I see, they'll be dust.
Uh-huh. Yep. What's that?
They'll forget. Things blow.
Well, I'm actually quite happy to resign from the garden club. It took a little way too much of my time. I'm actually excited to get down at it.
Stop playing.
Then you don't look so miserable.
I'm not. Just tired.
Hello? Oh, of course. Oh, just a second. I'm afraid it's one of them.
Oh, already? Hello? Hello, Gertrude. What? Oh no, this is terrible. Oh yes, go right over. Oh, poor thing. Goodbye. Poor Mrs. Wembley.
Poor Mrs. Wembley?
Oh, her daughter. She loved her.